right under the tape of Jason Chimera.
Well, you said you think he has a little bit. Whoa, jeez, Luis Ondrej.
The goalie down at the other end.
Ondrej Pavelec is down. This
does not.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, boy.
Ondrej Pavelec flat on his back. Greg Smith.
They're calling for everybody. They've got to get out there in a hurry.
Doctors coming from the sideline. Greg Smith off the Capitals bench. Just 2 minutes and 25 seconds into this contest, and Phillips Arena, stunned silence. Whistle far away from the play, and Craig Ramsey's netminder went down in a heap and has remained motionless. Obvious looks of concern in the stands. Well justified. This was not the end result of a collision or a slap shot that hit him in any way, shape, or form. Our attention was trained at the other end of the rink. There was a whistle, and then there was medical personnel streaming off of both benches as they reacted to the fallen netminder.
Well, that says it all. The fans stunned. We are stunned up here beyond belief.
Just getting started with the 2010 season in a surreal fashion. We wish the best for Ondrej Pavelec, the netminder for the Thrashers. No score, we'll get you back in a moment, right here on Comcast Sportsnet. Medical personnel from both teams continuing to tend to the fallen Atlanta Thrasher netminder Ondrej Pavelec. Pavelec, just as we were going to break, fell awkwardly. 23-year-old native of the Czech Republic, a fourth-year pro, and as best we can tell from our view on high, has not moved a muscle. Let's see if we can share a peek at Pavelec on his way down.
And it's going to be in the top left corner of your television sets. Here he is up here in the corner, and we'll see what transpired. This is what we could pick up as the whistle was blowing for an icing call. And there he is, going down, Joe.
Oh, my goodness.
Right when he was in his stance.
Oh, my goodness.
They're bringing more personnel out. Another doctor, it looks like, coming down with the linesman from the far end. Might have been in the stands watching this game, getting more people involved here with their fallen netminder.
It obviously does us no good to speculate, but you and I were racking our brains to think of anything similar that we may have seen or heard or read about. And names like Yuri Fisher and Sergei Zoltok come to mind.
Yeah, Fisher's the one that came to mind immediately with what happened to him and transpired with him on the Detroit Red Wing bench.
Thoughts and prayers go out to Ondrej Pavelec. 42 appearances last year. Craig Ramsey was saying so many good things about him this morning, that he had earned this start, that he had outplayed the newcomer brought in, Chris Mason. And just 2 minutes and 25 seconds into this opening period, a very scary moment in Atlanta. Friends, we need to step away. Say your prayers for Ondrej Pavelec as he has moved off the ice here at Phillips. Well, where do you find the words for this? Capitals and Thrashers, 2 minutes and 25 seconds into the contest, a new season with all the excitement, all the emotion that surrounds it. And if you are just tuning in on Comcast Sportsnet, a delay upwards of 5 to 6 minutes now. Ondrej Pavelec, the starting goaltender for the Thrashers, 2.5 minutes and change into this contest, fallen to his back, trying to sneak a peek in. He fell back after a whistle, was not, to our vantage point, struck by a player or a puck.
No, it was on an icing call.
It didn't seem to be anything that was residual. And down he went, and immediately, in lightning quick fashion, medical personnel from both teams sprinted off of their respective benches. Doctors came over the boards and onto the ice. And they are taking every precaution with Ondrej Pavelec as his Thrashers teammates salute him. And he gets a thunderous round of applause from those inside of Phillips Arena. It's not often that sports broadcasters have to become news reporters, but to our vantage point again, to our eyes, we did not see anything that resembled CPR being administered by doctors or trainers.
Nope, and it's not often that we're speechless, John. No. I'm just speechless to start this game when you see a young athlete go down like that with no one around him and now getting that medical help that he needs here as he leaves this arena at Phillips Arena here in Atlanta.
Ondrej Pavelec, just a few moments ago, you see him at the top left corner of your screen in nets for the Thrashers,
And he did signal. You saw him signal to the bench, it looked like, Joe, with his left hand up in the air, and then down he went.
First trainer gets to him. Does not appear to be any words spoken, and that first Atlanta Thrasher trainer immediately signaled to the end zone for doctors and emergency medical technicians to get out there as quickly as possible. Teams are coming off of their respective benches to loosen up again. This delay is some 15 minutes in duration. And Chris Mason comes off of the bench. No warm-up will be allowed to him, although he's not far removed from the regular game warm-up. 34-year-old Alberta native. Played a career-high 61 games last year with the Blues. He won 30 of them. Pavelec was dynamite, according to Coach Craig Ramsey, in the latter stages of the preseason. Earned the start.
And, Joe, I'm not sure if this is a good situation because the referee is now on his headset, and to me, he's probably calling Toronto and getting a clarification of what we're going to do with this hockey game. It was such a moment here in Atlanta, and I saw him talk to each of the coaches, and now he's on the headset, and I would presume he's talking to the bosses in Toronto of the National Hockey League.
And for now, folks, we wish we could inform you, but we are helpless in our position here to learn until we are notified as to any prognosis regarding Ondrej Pavelec. But whenever you see an athlete fall like that, when there appears to have been no contact in the moments prior that would have necessitated something like that, you fear the worst. It's only natural. Veteran referees Chris Rooney and Wes McCauley presiding over this one. Just 2 minutes and 25 seconds into a brand new season, and with all the emotion bubbling up in these two teams who've become rivals through their division matchups over the years, anxious to get after it. And now Craig Ramsey has to rally his troops and somehow get them to remain focused upon the task at hand while one of their brethren, one of their teammates, has just been taken off the ice on a gurney. Officials have been in contact with the timekeeper's bench. Craig, you made a mention to one of the officials putting on the headset in contact with the video room, I am sure, in Toronto.
And I think they're going to come over now and talk to the coaches. I'm sure they found out something from Toronto, and they want to talk to each coach, which each one is talking to right now before maybe they start play here, if that's even going to happen.
Washington Capitals beginning the new season with 3 games in 4 nights. Bruce Boudreau, that's good to see, lightening up the mood a little bit. Caps with their home opener tomorrow. The New Jersey Devils are in town. The Devils are in action tonight, entertaining Dallas. We are at Phillips Arena, a delay of nearly 20 minutes. Joe Beninati and Craig Lachlan with you as we near the top of the hour. Alex Ovechkin and the Capitals squaring off with the Atlanta Thrashers, and the Thrashers starting netminder, Ondrej Pavelec, at a whistle and a stoppage in play, collapsed to his back right in front of the Atlanta.